exciting. You know, game five, Vegas, Annabelle's bringing it. Almost pulled the handle right off that horn. And here we go.
Buck is down and off we go in game five. Here's Brett Howden coming off a two-goal game in game four on Monday. That win in Winnipeg amid the whiteout for Vegas. Of note, no Braden McNabb in this one. He's out with an upper body injury. They score! Chandler Stephenson in the opening minute.
You know what, Mike? I just had a visit watching the Vegas Golden Knights bench, and the fourth line just had a huge celebration because they set the tone for this. Chandler Stephenson comes out with his line mates, and look at the chemistry between Mark Stone and him. You know, Mark Stone just keeps it on his stick, makes it look to Hellebuck that he might shoot this puck, so he has to come out and challenge ever so slightly.
Now Marchessault, team leader in goals in the regular season. Hutton thought about it. Shadowed out high, looking for a lane. Rebound for Waugh, and Hellebuck the stop.
Ben Hutton getting an opportunity on this power play as he's in the Vegas lineup, and this is just a simple play. Just get it by the top screen.
Coming out of the first period here at the Fortress, and the Jets with their backs against the wall. Here Luc Dubois' line starts out. Chandler Stephenson's line begins for Bruce Cassidy. Samper in the direction of Dubois. Stone loves it down in the slot. Scores! 42 seconds into the second.
And he makes the Winnipeg Jets just simply turn the puck over. Look at him, continues to move his feet. Feet rushes DeMello to make that rim pass rather than a tape-to-tape pass. It gets turned over at the hash marks and goes right to Mark Stone in a very similar place where he was on the Chandler Stephenson goal. Finds the middle of the ice, and this time he's the shooter with a little bit of traffic in front with Howden there as well.
They were chirping at each other in the first. They ride one another back through neutral ice. Centering pass toward Domestikov, bounces away and picked up by Vegas. Petrangelo up ahead for Carlson. Speeding in. Carlson drops in the direction of Amadio. Up the wall from DeMello. Smith toward the net. A triple take. Carlson scores! 3-0 Vegas.
Allows a quick transition for Vegas right up ice, and they attack the offside. They recognize that he's the guy that's playing a ton of minutes. This is just an unlucky bounce, though, off the skate of Lowry. It goes right to Amadio, who puts it down to Carlson. There you can see, that's Capo Bianco's skate that it goes off. And they're coming in waves now, Vegas are, against the Jets here in the second period.
Fourth goal of the series for William Carlson. Two goals and 3:59 for Vegas. One and more. And Hellebuck makes the save on Nick Waugh.
If Hellebuck doesn't make this save right here, that the game is over. I know there's a ton of time left, but this is a big one.
Kuhlman and Pahal ready to emerge from the box here in the second. Got her. Break wide feed. Dylan shoots. Short side for a follow the save.
And it's Brendan Dillon for the Jets who steps up into the play, joins the attack. He takes the initial shot. You can see it goes off the inside of the blocker on Brossoit initially, and it sits right in front. And Lowry's there to get the rebound, and look at that second effort by Brossoit, who's completely lost and out of his net. He pushes with that right leg, gets a little bit of help.
He doesn't have to change the way he plays. Opponents have to change the way they play.
So Brossoit and Linda with the robbery, and when it rains, it pours for Winnipeg. Vegas goes on the power play for the second time tonight. Stone to Stephenson. They score! 9 seconds in!
And this is the first power play goal that the Winnipeg Jets have allowed on the road in these playoffs and in this series. And just a quick puck movement. And you can see the back and forth between the defense up top, Eichel and the defense up top. Then they quickly go down low, which opens up the seam here to Stevenson. DeMelo just can't recover.
Back to the line. Pahal intentionally off the end boards. Retrieved by Jack Eichel. Back for Pahal. On net. Traffic in front. Still loose. Hellebuck the stop on Marchessault. They bat at it, and it's guided off wide into the corner.
Trying to do. Those dancers are not in the Vegas zone. So it might have worked here. 4-0.
Rebound generated a good chance for Barbashev, and Hellebuck made the save up high. White Cloud for Barbashev. Nudged ahead for Marchessault. Trying to catch Winnipeg in the change. Marchessault on the breaks. In deep for Eichel. Eichel worked it out for Barbashev out in front. And poked wide.
Crowd has been unbelievable. And, you know, that line has combined for 11 points since they put Brett Howden on that line last game.
In terms of the mental side and the struggles he's had to get to this point, Carlson nearly had a two-on-one opportunity for Vegas. Right back in, here comes Dubois on the backhand, fought off with the blocker, and then bounced wide on for Ossoir.
Previously, just that extra little flexibility with his right pad. The initial shot again goes to his blocker side, and the rebound comes right back to the Winnipeg Jets player and Barron off his own defender, and he's able to kind of move quickly to that right side.
Rangers took the first two, the Devils the last three, including earlier tonight. Here in Vegas, late third period. With a pulled goalie, Winnipeg trying to generate. They got it to Wheeler there from Connor. Wheeler back out in front, and Connor scores. With 5:38 to go, Winnipeg is on the board, and not done just quite yet.
And Connor, who didn't have any shots through the first two periods, you can just see everything to net, though. That's the mentality of the Jets as Wheeler takes the shot. And then he just throws it to the net as he sees Connor come in, and not much of a celebration there. They know they have a lot of work here left to do.
Tap back. Petrangelo's got it. Held in by Ehlers. Connor shovels back for Wheeler. Now Pionk, a one-timer. Blocked. Rebound. Save. They score. Dubois puts it home, and it's a two-goal game with 2:35 to go.
You're down 4-2. But again, back to the point it goes. Wheeler's up high. Pionk just puts it to net. You can see it bounces off initially. Brassois makes the initial save, but the rebound comes right back to Dubois. It's a smart little headsy play there by Connor. Protects it, keeps possession. Vegas Golden Knights are going to challenge right here.
For a missed stoppage, potentially. And so let's welcome in our rules expert, Dave Jackson.
Well, the centerman is not allowed to play the puck with his hand. Neither centerman is allowed to play the puck with his hand. It's actually a penalty. However, if it goes missed, you can't award a penalty based on the video review, but you can call a hand pass.
There was a missed game stoppage for a goal.
Well, and in the first round,